As machinists, when we find ourselves cutting the same kinds of features on lots of different parts over and over again, we start looking for shortcuts, ways to cut out on repetition. And as a CNC programmer, these shortcuts will take the form of custom subprograms and macro calls. Here is an extruded part that poses a unique challenge for us. All we've got to do is drill some holes. But if we use a regular drilling can cycle, our drill would feed all the way through our part, from top to bottom. Now, for a few holes on one part, I wouldn't care about this inefficiency. But for lots of parts or lots of holes, this would be an awful waste of time. So instead of using a regular G81 or G83 drilling can cycle, we are going to write our own cycle using just feed and rapid moves, G1s and G0s. Now our drill will feed through the top wall, rapid down through the empty middle, and feed through our lower wall before rapiding out. Now this isn't bad for one hole, but as we add more holes, we'd have to carefully copy and paste this code at every XY location that we want to drill. This is time consuming and is prone to all kinds of typos and mistakes. This is a really good practical example of a part that is just begging for an M98 subprogram call, or even a G66 modal macro call. And we're going to cover both right now. This is going to be good. We're going to take the feed, rapid feed moves that we wrote earlier and put them into their own separate program, a subprogram, giving it a unique program O number. Now here is our new main program, and here is our sub. Every time an M98 is reached in our main program, the control is going to reach out and run subprogram 1004. The p-value on the M98 line defines which O number sub to grab and run. In this case, both our main and our sub programs are stored in memory. This is a good way to program if the part never changes on us. But if we're going to be putting holes in all kinds of different positions, or if the dimensions of our part are going to change on us, then it's best to use a macro program. A macro call is similar to a regular subprogram call, but it can convey information to our subprogram through local variables. Now, when a G65 or G66 macro call is reached in a program, each of the letter variables on that line of code are written to a matching variable on the macro variable page. The R value is written to local variable 18. Which is then used as pound 18 in our macro subprogram. F is stored in variable 9 and accessed as pound 9 in our sub. I is stored in pound 4, and J is stored as pound 5. A list of all of our local macro variables, 1 through 33, are found in our manual, which is available for download from the website. Local variables are kind of temporary and are really only used when calling macro subprograms. Global variables can be used to store or reference almost anything else and are saved even if the machine power is cycled. Now, I wrote this simple macro program and I decided which variables we were going to use. Now, we will leave notes in our macro programs explaining how each variable is used in a specific context. Now, if we are using certain macros a lot, we could even put in a reference key for the variables as an M130 media file. Now, here is the cool part. G66 modal macro calls are modal. Now, these were introduced in software version 23.1201. And they're gonna call up our subprogram at each and every position we move to until a G67 command is reached within our program. And this is really neat because we can create our own custom can cycles to to do just about anything that we can think of. With a G66 and our extrusion drilling macro, we can enter a part height of 2 inches. That's J2.0 in this program. And it will drill, rapid drill, at every XY coordinate that we go to. And if we wanted to rotate our stock and drill on the wide side, we can adjust our part height by changing the J value on our G66 line to J1.0 for a 1-inch tall extrusion. This is a powerful option. Again, just check out the difference between our G81 program and our G66 extrusion drilling cycle. We could just post out all of our drilled holes using a G81 cycle from CAM, and then swap out that G81 line for our custom G66. Now, close it all out with a G67 at the end of the cycle, and we would be all set running our new custom G66 extrusion CAM cycle. Macro statements can be as simple or complex as needed. They can use simple math, or deeper Boolean logic statements that can do whatever we'd like this macro program that engraves a Julian date. We'll be making more videos on all of our subprogram and macro G-codes coming up soon, so be sure to subscribe and click on that notification button. And as far as today's video goes, we've got all of the programs ready to go for you. You can check them out and use them as examples. Just follow the link in the description to today's bonus content. Well, thanks for letting us be a part of your success and for watching this Haas Tip of the Day.